Hello everybody and welcome to the NSL. I'm Basskip and welcome to our very first game of the day. We've got two best of threes coming up. We are in the round of eight, so the quarterfinals of this event. And this is going to be Bird Gang up against Desert Eagle as our very first game for the playoffs of this competition. Again, I'm Basskip. I'm really excited to be here covering this event for you guys. I'm going to be solo casting for this one, trying to work out some more co-casters for the next couple of days. But anyway, welcome. It's great to have you here. And I am not going to be doing too much poking and prodding and trying to scope out. Well, I'm going to try and scope out what's going on. Probably not too much predicting from me as far as the draft is concerned. I just want to see how this Korean Dota is going to unfold before our eyes, because this is, again, everybody's first look into what's going on right now. Reserve time. So, yeah, we're going to have a ban on Lone Druid and Nakes to start, and Visage is going to be banned by Bird Gang. Again, I have no idea what kind of bans and picks we're going to be seeing here. I know that all the jokes have been, okay, micro-intensive heroes are obviously overpowered in the hands of Koreans, so they need to be banned out. I guess we've got the Lone Druid and the Visage to start us off, and a Batrider here as well from Bird Gang. So there's still a Treant Protector, there's still, wow, okay. Looks like Desert Eagle know exactly what they want. They're going to snap up the Magnus. There's still Aerobic in the pool. I'd like to see Bird Gang get their hands on that at the very least. And then perhaps something else again. This is a bit of an interesting event because I feel like the teams really need to be playing, just play to their strengths. Even if you've been watching a lot of really high-level Dota, I don't know exactly what we've been what we're expecting here, but hopefully the teams won't think, okay, we need to, you know, try and put on too much of a show. Just play some solid Dota, and just, I guess, looking forward to seeing what they've got. So we are going to have Rubik as the pickup, along with the Queen of Pain. Quap going to do fantastic against the Magnus on mid. So we'll probably see, well, hopefully see some reasonably aggressive supports from Desert Eagle, perhaps with the opportunity to go and get some ganks on a Quap, because she will get great farm against the Magnus. And Magnus now, with the nerfs that he suffered, he doesn't really have the damage to combo down the Queen of Pain once he gets level 6, level 7, which was previously an option for him if he managed to get some harassment down earlier on. But just with the damage nerf on RP, it's not really a feasible thing anymore. What else have we got going on? Nick's Assassin is going to be the pickup, so double melee so far. Nick's obviously quite strong. Just in general, we haven't seen quite so much of him of late. He has been, you know, been showing his weakness a bit as far as being a melee support is concerned, but still going to be taken here. So it's kind of looking a little, it's still looking 6.7, I mean 6.78-ish style. Darks is going to be the ban, Keeper of the Light as well. So at least what I'm getting here is maybe a bit of an SEA kind of vibe. It's similar bands, but the Lone Druid's thrown in there, so that's a little bit different, I guess, more Western Dota. So if anybody, yeah, wants to know my thoughts on that, then that is the style that appears to be developing before us, at least right now. We've still got tons more games and still a bunch of teams that we haven't seen just yet. If anybody's interested in FXO, they're actually a team that's kind of comprised of a bunch of people from a bunch of different scenes, and they've actually got their very, they've got a kind of unique style as far as their play is concerned, so looking forward to casting them. They had a great showing in the AMD Premier League just recently, so I feel like they're actually the favorites in the eyes of a lot of people to take out the whole competition, and they're going to be playing their first game for the playoffs tomorrow. So I'd encourage you guys, if you're around, to definitely tune into that one. We're going to have Darkseer and Gyrocopter as the bans here for Desert Eagle, Bird Gang getting rid of the Keeper of the Light and the Shadow Demon. We've got one support so far for Deagle, but still looking for a second. Similar story for Bird Gang, but Bird Gang, they're going to be taking a Wisp here, and I'm looking forward to this, honestly. We'll see how Desert Eagle end up dealing with it. There's still all the great Wisp pairs in the pool, and Bird Gang looking pretty aggressive right now. So we'll see how Desert Eagle do end up responding. Oh yeah, anybody who's interested, if you want to, then you can tune in via the client. All the games are free. I've got my microphone open, you know, camera perspective is there. All the casters should have their mics open and ready. I don't know if there's any item drops enabled. We'll figure that out as soon as we see First Blood. But yeah, I'm Apologies, guys, the fact that there's no other resolution options aside from 720p on this stream. It's a new Join Dota stream. They still haven't sort of... They still haven't finished all of the setup, as far as that's concerned. So, yeah, that's the situation right now. But again, if you want to watch in client, I would definitely encourage you to do so. Jakiro's going to be the second pickup here for Deagle. Kind of tanky, but will be relatively susceptible to those CK Wisp relocate ganks. And Bird Gang, they're running CK Wisp right now. They're just looking for an offlane hero to wrap things up. And then we're looking for a carry and an offlane for the side. Just for the side of Deagle right now.
5 seconds remaining.
For anybody wondering what the version is, we are fully up to date as far as what the version is. So Wisp's tether move speed is now 17%. You can't really see that well through the overlay. But all of the most recent changes are through. We're on, I think everybody's just on the English client. I don't think the Korean local client is super available just yet. But yeah, for anybody wondering, we're fully up to date. Everything has been tweaked that way. And Faceless Void going to be the choice here for Deagle. So they've got a pretty heavy teamfight lineup going on. I like the Void choice. He will be able to time walk away from those relocate ganks. Relatively survivable. They've got great teamfight between the Magnus, the Faceless Void, and the Jakiro. The only problem is going to be getting leveled and avoiding the aggression from the Bird Gang squad right now. They're just looking for an offlaner. I'm surprised to see that they actually banned out Darkseer. I feel like they maybe could have got their hands on it, and obviously would have been fantastic with the lineup that they're running so far. They could run the Magnus as the offlane and pick up something like a Puck to match up against the Queen of Pain mid. They've got reasonable ganking supports in the Nyx Assassin and the Jakiro, so they might be able to get some ganks on the co-op if they want to try and make some space for the Magnus. Though, I feel like still just putting the mag on the offlane could be an option, just depending on how aggressive they feel Bird Gang is going to be in lane. I mean, they're definitely going to be running a safe lane. There's no chance that Faceless Void isn't going to have supports and that he isn't going to be on the safe lane. Bird Gang, I feel like they're probably going to run a safe lane tri-lane as well, just so that they can get the levels up on the Wisp and get those options online as quick as they can. As far as offlane heroes for both sides, there's still a Windrunner in the pool. There is still a Bounty Hunter as well. We've been seeing a little bit of Bounty Hunter comboing with the CK Wisp just to get that track vision going for slightly easier reality rifts. It's kind of a big deal now because the vision on the spirits got nerfed so that you only get vision now if they actually pop on somebody, and that can make it a little bit more difficult to actually get that first reality rift to start off the gank immediately after a relocate. So track is always a nice thing to have in that kind of situation. Nature's Prophet is going to be the ban, very natural, fits into the offlane, jungle as well, and also, you know, more global presence on top of the CK Wisp. And if you'd had that Nature's Prophet, you could have had the Queen of Pain waiting behind a tree, she blinks out, Prophet TP's in, and then, you know, Chaos Knight and Wisp swoop in out of nowhere. So I think a very respectable ban here. From Deagle and Bird Gang, how are they going to wrap it up? If they want a little bit more sort of global presence, yeah, they could take the Rattle Trap here. So, going to take Clockwork, they've got Hookshot. They don't have a Prophet to TP in, but they've got a Hook to set up for Relocate Ganks as well. And if you can jump onto the Faceless Void, then you can prevent him getting a good Chronosphere. It's even more initiation to help deal with the Magnus. If you can jump on him before he jumps on you, then you're already in a good position because they are kind of relying on the RP to be initiation, at least until the Faceless Void maybe gets a BKB, and he probably isn't going to get a BKB first. He does need to get at least one farming item, be it a Midas, be it a Battle Fury, be it a Maelstrom, something along those lines. Again, these predictions could be woeful, guys, and we could see completely different item builds and completely different strategies, but so far it's looking pretty familiar, I have to say. And one last pick here for Deagle. That is Deagle, by the way, guys. So their namesake is on the team. They're just not playing with their team tags and whatnot right now. And they're gonna grab even more team fight. They're gonna grab the Warlock here. So I'm not exactly sure how they're gonna end up laning this. But these questions and more will be answered once we get ourselves into the game, and everybody's just going to pick up their heroes right this second. So a reminder, guys, we are in the Nexon Starter League. We are in the round of 8, or the quarterfinals. I'm Basskip. I'm here in association with joinDOTA to provide some English coverage of this event. And I hope you guys are having a great day and looking forward to seeing what the Koreans have in store for us with their debut in Dota 2. Over on the side of Desert Eagle, we are going to have the man himself playing the Jakiro. Kane is going to be on the Faceless Void. We've got Move Your S on the Magnus. Keeping On is going to be on the Nyx Assassin, and Shabelle on that Warlock. Over on the side of Bird Gang, we have TB on the Clockwork. Hell Symphony is going to be on the Chaos Knight. Furious on the Wisp. Big Bird on the Rubick. And MP is going to be on that Queen of Pain. Again, I'm very intrigued by this Warlock pickup. I'm interested to see how these lanes are going to be run. Could be an offlane Magnus, a support Warlock, and a mid Nyx. It could alternatively be an offlane Magnus, a support Nyx, and a mid Warlock. So we'll see what they end up going for here. They could even maybe do a really weird duo mid with the Faceless Void farming and the Warlock backing him up. That's a very old school strategy with Warlock as a babysitter. But could see it coming out here. Could be an option for them. Now we've got a little bit of a pause. Not exactly sure what's going on. Maybe some technical issues that we need to resolve. But yeah, I am excited. Yeah, it's Move Your S, but his name on the official documentation is Move Your Ass. So I think I'm just going to call him Move Your Ass. We've disabled chat filtering, and we've... I guess I can be a little bit more... I can be a little bit more PG-13, 13+, or whatever, on the stream. I feel like cursing is probably fine. So, yeah, this is the one part of the day where I feel like I should have a co-caster, because there's not a whole lot to talk about. We're unpausing, but Big Bird is actually disconnected, so we're going to have another pause and try and resolve whatever issues are going on right now. Lordy lords. So, guys, a reminder about what path these teams have taken to get here. There was a qualifier stage that was also on LAN, so the teams that are here have already beaten out a couple of other teams in the Korean community, so these are, hopefully, the best 8 teams that they at least have to offer right now. So they're not just being randomly picked up. I think there were invites, there was definitely a qualifier stage, and now we are in the playoff portion of the competition. It's best of 3, single elimination, I believe. So it looks like we just need to have a very quick Dota restart or something along those lines, and then we'll be underway. As far as these lineups are concerned, I worry about how level-dependent Desert Eagle are. I mean, Bird Gang, they're not necessarily independent of levels, but they're not cooldown-based. So whenever the teamfight ultimates are on cooldown for the side of Deagle, then they might be in some trouble because, again, I mean, BG not really relying on too much. They've got maybe a Sonic Wave, they've got the Relocate, but it's nothing really compared to the Chaotic Offering, the RP, and the Chronosphere. And everybody's kind of level dependent. I mean, Magnus wants to get 6 really fast, Warlock wants to get 6 really fast, Void wants to get as many levels as he can, as quickly as he can. Jakiro would not mind having some levels, he's probably going to be the 5, and Nyx Assassin probably the 4, just to grab that level 6 as quickly as he can as well. I mean, having the Nyx Assassin at level 6 is going to be great. If they can get some pickoffs on the Wisp, then they can definitely slow down the aggression from Bird Gang. As far as maybe overall warding is concerned, again, we're hoping that Bird Gang are going to be able to be opportunists with their warding, that they're going to get some aggressive wards down and look to use those to get the relocate pickoffs and then turn those into pushes and hopefully not be stalled too much by the big AoE teamfight over on the Dire side. Meanwhile, for the Dire, they don't need to be too aggressive. Don't go for too many pickoffs. You just make sure that you have your ultimates up and fight in them. They've definitely got the better team fight lineup. So long as they don't get picked off, they should be okay. And Kane, it's looking like a Midas rush for him so far. He's going to start off with a QB, some tangos, and a salve. Move Your S. Looks like he's going to be making his way mid as the Magnus, kind of a standard bottle rush primed for him. Shabelle, he's going to pick up a Bassy to start. So that's a little bit interesting. We'll have to see what ends up happening with this one. Meanwhile, we do have Obs and Sense picked up by the remaining supports, though it looks like the offlane perhaps might be sacrificed. Shabelle kind of making his way down right now, but Warlock not really a great 3v1 hero. It looks like Bird Gang might just be going for an aggressive tri lane themselves. I'm kind of surprised. Again, I thought they might just run a defensive try, because of the Wisp, but I guess they want to put some pressure on the faces forward. And Void, without a stat shield to start, is going to have a hell of a time in this lane. He's definitely not expecting the aggressive tri-lane. The 1v1 matchup on bot is going to be Clockwork against Warlock. Warlock's not a bad 1v1 solo, but if Clockwork builds it right, he should be able to pick up some solo kills using the Battery Assault, despite the Shadow Word heal. Because Shabelle doesn't have a bunch of regen, he's got a Bassy for a little bit of mana regen, but that's not going to be great. And I think Clockwork has a more standard build. Well, he's got a stat shield and some tangos, so no salve. Everybody's running a little bit regen light, I would have to comment, as far as this is concerned. The tri-lane is reasonably well stocked, but the Clockwork solo, I mean, six tangos. Sometimes you'd like to see that be three tangos and a salve, or six tangos and a salve even. But looks like haste rune to start us off for the game. But yeah, Kayn is going to have a tough time on this top lane. Desert Eagle's a little bit regen light, he's only got some tangos. Keeping On has himself some tangos and a salve, so a little bit better for him there. And Bird Gang just choosing to block at the start right now. Looks like the creep wave going to end up in a reasonable position anyway. They've got some good aggressive warding going on, but it's not giving them any vision over the pull camp, so I'm surprised to see that this ward is actually all the way over here. And Bird Gang are actually the aggressors in this lane, so they should really be the ones with the more aggressive ward, perhaps behind the tower or something along those lines. But anyway, doing a good job so far. Creep wave's going to get split up. So it looks like Void going to grab his first couple of last hits of the game. Again, he's probably going to need to, I would think, buy a stout shield fairly early on. Meanwhile, MP on mid already driving the Magnus out of lane. Mag did manage to grab a couple of CS to start, but now he's low on mana. In a little bit of trouble against the Quap. And this is the other nice thing about the aggressive tri-lane from Bird Gang. It prevents the supports from ever rotating to deal with the Queen of Pain. And she's going to win this 1v1 matchup by herself. The Clockwork should do fine on the bottom lane. Shabelle just focusing on harassment right now. But yeah, that's the other nice thing about running the aggressive try. And if they get kills, then Wisp will still get levels. Desert Eagle needs to be really careful going forward for these pot shots. I mean, they've got a stun to help bail him out, but the Faceless Void is completely useless. He's not going to time walk in for a slow. He doesn't have a bash. He's got nothing but, you know, sort of pseudo-survivability right now. So I'm surprised to see that Bird Ganger letting them get away with just sitting everybody in the lane right now. Nobody is attempting to run any pulls. The Nyx Assassin is just hanging around to hope to use his stun. Move your S on mid. Already getting harassed out. He grabbed three last hits at the start and hasn't added any since. MP doing a great job. Salve going to get cancelled, though. So a bit of a win there for Move Your S. Meanwhile, on the bottom lane, Warlock doing a pretty good job. 8 for nil. TP just keeps getting harassed every single time he comes in for a last hit. He hasn't gotten a single mana burn off yet on the Warlock. They're going to jump on top of the Void. He's going to be able to time walk his way out. Pops that salve, so that's the first attempt on his life for this top lane. And Move Your S actually going to make his way down and pick up an invis. That's our 2-minute rune waiting for him there. But yeah, still no first blood just yet, so still no confirmation as to whether or not we do actually have items enabled for this competition. TB on bot, still doing pretty well, but hasn't gotten a single point of harassment really down on Shaw, it seems. He's still got some tangos left and doing a really good job of driving the Clockwork out. They're going to lift back Desert Eagle, the stun flies out, and that's going to be our first blood. We do have items up, guys, so anybody who wants to get in on that should either spectate, or I think it might be enabled through Twitch. I don't know if all that integration is being done for this competition, but first blood going to be drawn by Bird Gang up on top, and they do manage to punish Desert Eagle for his really aggressive positioning there. They should really be sitting back behind the Faceless Void, letting him get farm, and then throwing out stuns and damage if he gets initiated on. They shouldn't leave themselves open to possibly be the ones initiated on. And Move Your S, he's going to try and chop MP to death. On the middle lane, she just walks up into the fog. If there was a shockwave there, I think she was dead. But now MP going pretty aggressive. Still winning this middle lane really heavily, 21 for 9. CB kind of trading evenly on the bottom lane right now. So, yeah, TB, I still agree with the build. He's got 3 points up in the Battery Assault. He can definitely solo kill the Warlock if he manages to cog him in. Though Shabelle looking a little bit tankier now, he does still have that heal up. Move your S, gonna get his hands on another rune. MP jumps in. Just eat a little bit more harassment there. We've got Dire Squad just running some pulls, but Bird Gang gonna come in and intercept that. They're looking for the Realtor. It's back. It's going to be onto Desert Eagle. Where's the lift to follow up? He gets the ice path out, but I think that's going to be it for him. Are they going to be able to bring him down? Right click's going to do it. Nice micro there from Furious. But meanwhile, on mid, Move Your S is going to get a free kill. It doesn't seem like a free kill, but didn't take too much damage there. Gonna pick that one up on the Queen of Pain, so despite the rough start in terms of CS, picks that one up, now level 6, and can definitely be the guy that can look to make his way up towards the top lane to try and put some pressure on the try. As far as the levels there are concerned, Furious is now up to level 3.5. Move your S, he's got some boots, he's got a bottle. Their MP is still kind of winning this lane for now. TB on bot, he's got some boots, looks like he's not ferrying out anything because the courier is just going for his bottle. Yeah, so just a little bit of a bottle crow going on for him. That is a big reason as to why MP is so aggressively contesting these runes against the Magnus. Normally it should be his advantage. He's looking for the Sonic Wave, he just grabbed level 6, he's gonna jump into the trees, but a mana miscalculation is going to leave him with not enough. He will have another sting in a second if he can just find the Magnus. One more scream! No! Move Your Ass is juking! But will the right clicks be enough? There's the sting, there's one more right click, and MP will be able to pick up the kill, eating a bunch of tower shots at the same time. So he gets his revenge there. Shabelle gonna be picking himself up some phase boots. And he's now also level 6, so he's got that big ultimate ready. And he can probably look to make his way up towards the top lane to put some pressure on this tri lane as well. Similar story for the Clockwork, he's now got his hookshot. So can start looking for some more aggressive kills. And I was worried that the teamfight ultimates wouldn't quite be up and ready for the side, for the side of Deagle, but with this aggressive tri-lane running, the Whispery Locate isn't going to be there early, and that's giving them a little bit of space. Meanwhile, Sonic Wave is also up for MP, so we've got huge weapons all around the map, and we're just waiting for them to be used, really. We'll see where the Quap ends up going. She's going to make her way down towards the bottom lane to try and kill off the Warlock. TB's off to the side. Is he going to look for the hookshot? He's got an angle right now. He jumps in. Cogs is a man. He's going to drop the ultimate as well. I don't know if this helps him escape. Healing himself. He's going to be brought down. TB going to be chased by the Golem, but I think he'll be fine. And that's going to be it. And even keeping on, going to be teeping his way down towards the bottom lane. I feel like Warlock should have just accepted his death and then used the Golem maybe later on the top lane. Not the best start for him. As far as our overall start is concerned, it's a 2k gold lead in favor of the Radiant, and about a 2k experience start for them. Faceless Void actually not doing too badly in terms of CS, though. Only 19 for now. Does already have his Midas recipe, but he's going to get Reality Rifted back into a 3-second stun and into the burst. Yeah, that was kind of brutal. He's going for more points in Backtrack to try and get a little bit of survivability out, but doesn't really have the HP at this point. And yeah, Bird Gang gonna absolutely melt him down. So Faceless Void still struggling. The Chaotic Offering is on cooldown, so there's no bailout from that. And keeping on, grabs himself level 4, but now waddling his way back towards the top lane. Move Your Ass. Doing okay in terms of farm on mid. Is he gonna go for this? He gets the Shockwave, he gets the Skewer. I don't think the RP combo would have quite been enough. Again, its damage is kind of lackluster now, but very aggressive play from him. And MP gonna have to try and find that next rune, because I think TB is still just non-stop bottle crowing on bottom lane. Yeah, the courier is currently occupied. So this could get kind of dangerous for MP once he goes for the next rune. And he's just sitting a long way back right now, playing it defensively. They're both gonna abandon the lane, abandoning the experience for now. Checking the rune, it's actually on bot. Queen of Pain gonna blink her way down. And I think that's going to be it. Magnus gets the farm, but he surely is not gonna contest this one. He's got a skewer, but the Quap's got a blink. And there's a haste, and this could go really badly because they're going to see the Magnus as the hookshot ready. He almost kills MP. 22 HP left. I'm surprised to see that TB didn't go for the initiation there once he saw the Magnus make his way down onto the low ground. But yeah, still just wandering around for now. Big Bird going to be walking his way mid. He's kind of low on life. Wasn't really spotted. The Dire Ward is actually just blocking out the big pull camp right now to try and slow down the farm of the Wisp. But he's already level 5. Shabelle's gonna walk his way mid. The hookshot gonna fly in onto Move Your Ass, and he is stuck. He's got a skewer. He's gonna skewer back TB. Is he gonna be healed here? He will, but he's still gonna go down. Keeping on walks in at the same time, but only a carapace left, and that's gonna be another kill going the way of Bird Gang, now leading by 6. And it looks like they've just refreshed those aggressive wards again. I'm not quite sure why this ward is the preference, quite frankly. If it was even just a little bit further around the corner, they would get some vision sort of over here, which they don't really have right now. So that's a bit strange from them, just refreshing the exact same wards that they started the game off with. Shabelle, he's got that ultimate back off cooldown, so he could look to make his way top, and hopefully he will. Drop the wombo combo in the heads of the CK and the Wisp and hopefully kill them off, because these ultimates should really be kills. Even if you only use them on a single hero, an RP, a Chaotic Offering, a Chronosphere should hopefully guarantee you one pick off, and that should hopefully guarantee you some space, but that's not really the situation at the moment. Hell Symphony farming up well on top. It's going to be a straight armlet rush for him in terms of overall item progression. Kane still has this Midas recipe, but he doesn't have the Midas. They're going to Reality Rift onto Desert Eagle. He's in some trouble. 3 seconds stun. Good nuke. The spirit damage as well. Kane fighting for now, but needs to be careful. The CK a little bit low on mana. Not tread swapping to int at all, it would appear, when spamming out his spells. So that's a little something that he could work on. Is he going to go for it now? They're just going in. They've got one Reality Rift. Kane going to get hit by the tether stun. The creep is blocking off Hell Symphony. And now MP jumps in. He's got a Sonic Wave. They're going to cut their way into the trees. They've got Tangos. They spot Kane. He gets some right clicks, but that's going to be curtains for him. Down he goes, and still no Hand of Midas for him right now. Move your S, makes his way up. He's got a rank 3 Skewer. He throws the Shockwave. He's got the RP, jumps in. Double damage pops off for MP. Shabelle, he's here. He's going to drop the rock. It's only on the edge of Hell Symphony. They drop the RP on him as well. And they bring him down. The Shockwave going to be enough. Now move your S. Being healed up with the double damage from the Queen of Pain will be enough. They right click him down, and now the hookshot flies in from TB. Jumping out of the way of the ice path, scream back over the top. TB gonna pick up that kill. Big Bird walks down from the low ground. Desert Eagle goes for the right clicks with the double damage still up on the Quap. The Golem doing what it can. Ice Path's gonna connect. Will the Golem finish him off? TB trying to escape. Big Bird goes for the body block. Salve will pop. Golem gonna not get the right click there. Looks like he got outranged. So that's going to be it. Top lane, Bird Gang leading the game 12-2, and we still have not seen a single relocate used, and that's now available for Furious. So those pickoffs will be coming up soon. Meanwhile, Kane has been making his way down towards the bottom lane. He's almost got that Hand of Midas finished. He's so painfully close. He's now level 6 as well, so he's got the Chronosphere to try and help out his team, but Faceless Void needs a heck of a lot of space right now. This is now a recovery Midas. This is no longer a farming Midas. This is the Midas that gets the Void back into being relevant in the game, not the Midas that gets him ahead. MP gonna jump in aggressively on the middle lane. Move your ass. You don't have RP. You can't really threaten the Quap right now. And he's gonna end up backing out. MP just with some treads right now. Gonna do a bit of tread switching to bottle up. So nicely done by him. Kane's gonna jump down, ignoring farm to come and steal the Invis rune. So preventing the Queen of Pain from grabbing onto that one. They do have a ward down here, so keeping tabs on the rune at the very least. But Faceless Void looking a little bit homeless right now. He's not up on top lane. Shabelle is just chilling out there right now. It's going to be a straight Aghanim's rush for him. Dire's bottom and tower Furious and Hell Symphony, they're going to be looking for these relocate pickups coming up soon. Move your ass. Might be in some trouble here. Do the supports have TP scrolls? They don't. Desert Eagle completes his magic wand before he buys boots. That's a little bit questionable. Meanwhile, Reality Rift goes out. 4 seconds stun onto Deagle. And they're gonna bring him down. Again, there is no reason. There is no reason in the at all to finish your magic wand before you buy boots. This is what a magic wand gets you. It combines 4 item slots into 1, and it gets you 5 additional capacity on the stick. So you go from 10 maximum charges to 15. But at this stage of the game, Jakiro has a bunch of spare inventory space, and he spent gold that's not really helping him do anything. He should have really bought boots. The relocate's gonna go down towards bot, but Kane almost gets solo killed. He's gonna throw out the Chronosphere. They're gonna drop the rock. Can they get the combo going on? The Phantasms pop off. Furious, they're gonna split up the team. The Tether, he's gonna make his way back in as they will escape and bring down Kane with the burst damage. They lift up Shabelle. Where's the steal from Rubik? He's actually got Shockwave. Grab the Chaotic Offering, unless the heal was used afterwards. But now, MP jumps in. Sonic Wave to clean up one. The Fade Bolt flying through. Down drops the Jakiro. Your ass. He jumps in. Can he get the kill? He doesn't have enough mana. He gets lifted up into the air. Big Bird throws him back into the Nyx Assassin. The Golem giving chase. Big Bird trying to juke out of the way. The Golem is closing the gap. Can he bring him down? I think he might be able to. Run, Big Bird, run! Where's the jukes? You gotta get this! No, the Magnus! He cuts off the escape route. He's gonna shockwave him right in the face. And that's gonna be the end of that. And wow, the Golem gonna give chase onto MP. Throws a scream. He's got another blink. But I think that's gonna be it. Is he gonna get the kill? He needs to be careful that those flaming fists don't kill him. And MP will end up surviving. The Golem kind of gargling his way towards death there. But yeah. So, BG looking pretty good for them. They've got the armlet up on the Chaos Knight. He's got another 1.4k gold in the bank. So if he wants a drum or some progress towards a BKB, he could do that. Oh, Hookshot's gonna connect onto Keeping on the bottom lane. He's gonna pop the Vendetta, but a Sentry Ward immediately used. Bird Gang, ready as ever to pick that one up. The 4-staff is gonna be the rush here for TB. I don't mind it. It's nice on the clockwork. I'd like to see a mech a little bit more, but no big deal overall. And nice to be able to get a bit of mana burn going, and especially on someone like the Void. You can jump him, you can hookshot him. Speaking of Faceless Void, he's getting jumped on top. He's going to be able to time walk himself 600 units. But unfortunately, that's only level 1 right now. He's got some boots, but he's 0 for 4 for 0, so not having a fantastic game. And MP showing what a Snowballing Queen of Pain is all about. 6 for 1 for 4, just looking for pickoffs all around the map. Move your ass, gonna get lifted up on mid. He's got an RP, I think he could just burst down Big Bird here. He's gonna try and skewer himself away, but I think the Quap gonna close the gap, and now the relocate comes in from Furious. It's only solo, but they pick up the kill. Mega kill streak for him, 5 for 0 for 7. And yeah, not looking great for the Deagle side right now. TB gonna pick up a tower for himself on bot. They've got all these ultimates, but we just haven't really seen them used in concert, and that's really what they need. They've been trying to be a little bit aggressive with the solo pickoffs and the ults, and I said that's definitely an option, but right now I think they just need to sit back behind the towers, let BG push into them, and then RP and everything when they come, because right now things are just not working out well. Kane, he's Midasing lane creeps right now. He wants to try and stay in the lane as much as he can to get the farm that he sort of deserves, but that means he's not really picking up levels. As far as levels are concerned, he's sitting close to the bottom of the pile, close to the rest of his team. And if he was Midasing jungle creeps, then he would be getting a lot more experience out of it. And he's not getting that much efficiency out of using it on these creeps in lane. So I'm a little bit surprised at that one from the Faceless Void. And I think as somebody in chat rightly pointed out, his very first hand of Midas for the game was on a ranged creep. So not getting a ton of EXP out of that one. Hell Symphony, looks like he's just going to be picking up a Vitality Booster, a little bit tankier there. Looks like he's going to be making his way towards the Heart first, I would suppose. I mean, there is a lot of BKB Pierce over on the side, over on the Dire side, but a BKB would keep him up through everything because there's absolutely no right-click damage right now. So I think there's probably an argument to be made for the Heart as well. We'll see if he ends up maybe finishing that now or maybe going back for something similarly cost efficient. They're gonna pop a smoke on bot. They've got everybody here. They don't have their ultimates though. No RP. They do have the Golem. They do have the Chronosphere. RP only a few seconds away. They don't have a Blink Dagger up on this Magnus. And still no boots on these supports. Again, they chose to... Well, they do have boots up on the next Assassin, but again, don't complete your wands before you buy boots, guys. It's just not the right choice. The Rowdy Earth goes in. They don't get the stun. Breaking the tether there. Hookshot looked like it connected, but Deagle with a quick sidestep, gonna avoid that one there. TB still chasing in. They throw another Reality Earth. They're gonna try and chase them back in from the side. It's move your ass. Can he get a hero RP? What's gonna be stolen by Big Bird? This could be trouble. He's got it ready, and there's so many ultimates that are about to fly that I think he should be able to get his hands on something. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Desert Eagle, they've decided that this is their defense, but what can they do? No! Move your ass, he's gonna get stuck by TB. Are they gonna be able to bail him out? He gets the skewer over the top, but TB gets the cogs, he four-staffs himself out, they jump on top of Shaw Bell. Can he get the ultimate down before he drops? He will drop the Chaotic Offering, but Kane is extremely low on life, he's gonna back off, move your ass. He jumps in, but he doesn't get the RP, chain stun to death, 5 for nothing, the Golem to be cleaned up as well, double kills for the Queen of Pain and Hell Symphony. And Bird Gang gonna be able to pick up the tier 2 tower as well. That is going to be 24-3, 15k gold, 15k experience. And Bird Gang looking very, very strong as they make their way up onto the high ground. The Phantasms were used for that fight. Hell Symphony just being healed up right now. And TB deeper in the base, keeping on. He's got the Vendetta again, but Hookshot's in. MP jumping over the top. Desert Eagle completely stuck. Reality Rift going out. It actually manages to stun Keeping On in the middle of his Vendetta. They have no idea where he is, but he keeps getting bounced around. Tether stun and the cogs there. They're gonna jump in. They drop the chrono. It's only on one. Big Bird, where's the stun? Where's the steal? He's waiting on the RP. Patience from him right now. It still hasn't been used. Kane gonna be dragged in. 4 seconds stun on him. Move your ass. Jumps in. Where's the RP? He's skewered into the tether stun. That's gonna be the end of him. Keeping On, getting stunned from the low ground. MP with the BKB in the back lines. Shawbell gonna try and heal himself up. Keeping On gonna be brought down. And now Shawbell, one last right click. That is going to be it. Triple kill for Bird Gang. Distributing some items to the fans right now. And looks like this is pretty much it. One Rax down. Bird Gang in control of a huge advantage. They don't have tier 2s down in the other lanes just yet. But at this point, not looking great for the Dire side. And they almost had that wombo combo, but things just getting interrupted here and there.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
And heading up towards the top lane, they're just going to grab more farm. Furious has 2k gold, hero level, not painting a very pretty picture right now. Nor is net worth. The Hand of Midas Faces Void is below the farm of Big Bird right now. And move your ass, that's going to be it. They're going to call the GG, they're going to tap out, and Bird Gang walking away with the very first game of the playoff stage of the Nexon Starter League. Again, guys, it's a best of three, so don't go too far. Next game coming up soon after this best of three. We do have another whole best of three as well, so plenty of Korean Dota action coming your way. I've been Basskip. I've been here in association with joinDOTA, so thanks for those guys for having me on to cast. Remember to give your stream the support, give them a follow, all of that stuff. If you guys want to check out the stuff in between the game, then I encourage you to check out the GOM TV GOM TV _EN stream if you want to see what's going on at the LAN event itself. But again, don't go too far. Next game will be coming up in about 5 minutes, I believe. We do have a guaranteed 5-minute break for the teams between matches. So they'll put on some more music. Again, it's been a pleasure casting for you guys so far, and looking forward to see what else we have coming up today. So this is Basskip for game 1. I'll be back soon.